I want to share a dream with you I had in December, right before Christmas. Some of you might consider it eerie, some might consider it exciting, some might consider it mesmerizing, as I did. But I know there's good and bad involved in it, and I believe it's a warning dream. We are in the last days. Let me share this dream, and you draw the conclusion per your prayer life. I dreamt I was outside. This was an area I knew nothing about. It wasn't familiar. But there weren't a lot of buildings. There was a lot of land. And I noticed that as I was standing outside, I was looking up and I was looking at this tree. I was mesmerized. It was almost like a rounded shaped tree. It wasn't humongous. It was just maybe 2 feet above eye level for me. And I'm 5'6". So I figured the tree might have been between 7 and 8 foot tall. It really wasn't a tall tree and obviously wasn't an old tree. But be that as it may, I'm looking at the tree and the tree burst into sudden flames. I mean, the flames were explosive. And it just caught me by surprise. But I noticed the tree was not burning. It wasn't being consumed. It was just a flame. So I'm looking at all these flames. And I was so mesmerized. I wasn't paying anything else any attention. And then the thing just, it just doused out. It just all of a sudden went out. But then I saw sparks and it burst aflame again. And I said, oh my goodness, this reminds me of the vision and of Moses with the burning bush. And I'm thinking, oh, maybe I'm getting ready to see a vision, or maybe God's getting ready to talk to me or give me a warning or something. I didn't know what was going to happen. So I'm mesmerized by the beauty of the flames because they were beautiful. They were not scary to me. However, even though I knew they were holy, I also knew the day was eerie. It was daytime, but it was very dark and gloomy all behind and all out and around us. The clouds were thick. Very gloomy, cloudy day. But the beautiful part of it was this tree bursting into flames. I'm staring at this tree and I'm taking it all in. And I noticed it was very quiet. Eerily quiet. And next thing I know, something got my attention and I looked over my shoulder and I saw this guy standing on a porch and the door was open. He was holding it open, beckoning for me to come inside the house. Well, as I'm wondering, he points as if he heard my question. He points up to my upper left. And when I look, over to the distance, maybe around 2 or 3 miles away, maybe 4, I'm not sure, there were 3 tornadoes. Now, the sky was dark gray, thick with clouds, but the tornadoes were whitish. They were almost white in color. And I would say, if I were to guess, maybe they were a half a mile to a mile apart. Not sure, but there were 3. So I'm looking at the tornadoes and now I'm getting a whiff of something brewing and I didn't feel any fear. And the guy said, come inside. Well, I looked up at the tree almost in regret that I had to stop looking at this beautiful miracle I'm watching. And all of a sudden I noticed a white dove flying and hovering over the top of the tree. Oh, it was beautiful. So I hurried up and I turned around as I glanced back at the tornadoes and I went in. I didn't see myself go inside. All I know is the next second I'm inside of the house. Okay. Now I'm walking into the house. I'm actually in the house. I'm actually entering the living room. Let's put it like that. And to my right, I'm looking at women. It looks like there may be 3, 4, 5. In my mind, I think there were 3 women and others, but I couldn't quite remember that detail. And one woman was sitting with a hand on her hip, and they were pretty relaxed. their demeanor was really mellow. And I noted, I remembered when I woke up that there was no fear in that house. They were not afraid. They were not on high alert. They were mellow. They were very peaceful. No fear in the house whatsoever. I entered into this hallway looking for the strongest part of the structure of the house, you know, just in case. And I was taught that from my mother, and you know, from young adulthood, when she always said, look for the strongest part of the structure if there's an earthquake or whatever. So that's where my mind was. Well, I'm in the hallway. This little boy comes and walks up to me, and he doesn't say anything, but he stands there with me. And I think I sat down in the hallway or something, I don't know, but I remember the boy was standing over me and he was just looking at me very peacefully, but he wanted to be with me for some reason. Now, next thing I know, it's bright daylight. It actually became bright daylight when I was looking at the women and I noticed it was light. It was bright outside. When I was in the hallway, it seemed like all the bright daylight and the sunlight was coming into the house. Well, next thing I knew, we're all looking out the window and we're praying. I knew I was in a house full of born-again Christians. I just knew that. I'm looking out the window with the rest of them, and I'm thinking in my mind, oh, please don't let anybody's house get hurt. Please don't let anybody get hurt, injured, or killed. I'm thinking this, and I know they're praying it too. It's just a knowing. Do you know, as the sun was shining bright and nothing was moving, all of a sudden I see this big old fat tornado strolling down the street as if it was out on a Sunday afternoon stroll. It was the most bizarre thing. It didn't destroy anything. When I looked when I looked across the street, the neighbor's house had something hanging off the hinge, but nothing was damaged. I mean, badly damaged. It was an easy repair. When I looked outside the window, when we went outside and I looked at the house, the front of the house, the only damage was there was a little wood chipping away right at the corner of the right where the roof hits the base of the roof of the house, where there's always like a wood edging around. Well, that was the only thing that was chipped away a little bit right at the corner. That was it. And the day was bright and sunny and beautiful. And I knew my safety was with the saints. I knew my safety was inside. And all I have to say to you guys is, please, whatever you do, draw close to God in these last days. Because I'm telling you, the word the Lord gave me for December 31st at a church was, get ready for battle, dress for it, prepare for it, but know that if you are all the way in Christ, God has already given us the victory. And know that you will do battle, even though you know you're going to win, but you will have to do some battle, babe. So get real close to God and through here. We don't know what's coming. And we have to pray for our divine, supernatural, physical protection. We have to pray for protection against the demonic. We have to pray against things that are happening in high places. We have to pray. There's wickedness in high places, and high places has a whole lot more meaning than what we attribute to it. So ask God to walk you through and warn you and tell you where you need to be at certain times of the year, okay? All I know is I felt like the Lord had shown me in my mind's eye while I was speaking, the movie Angels in the Outfield. This is the good part of the story. For those who are all the way in Christ in their faith, we're not talking about their walk, that's between you and God, all the way in Christ. For those of you who are really clinging close to God, This is the word, I believe, for you and for me. Just like in Angels of the Outfield, there was a scene where this poor little pitiful team that couldn't catch a ball if you put it in the glove mitt. He ran to catch the ball. Now, this is when the angel started helping them. The angel flew down, swooped the guy up, and helped him catch the ball. He's flying through the air. Now, what that said to me during that message was, God is going to make things easily accessible to the saints. God is going to help us in the areas where we have need, where we end up in need because of what's going on. The needs will be met, not only miraculously, but easily, supernaturally. Things will happen and it'll amaze us how easy it was to get our needs met while all hell is literally breaking loose in this country. So pray, as the old saints say, pray mighty. Please do yourself and your loved ones a favor. It's get down time, saints. We don't know when God is coming. And I also uploaded some other videos from other people who are having dreams during December. Listen to those. They're on my Facebook page, Patricia Love. Look that up. You'll see a picture of me with my head cocked to the side and a little silly grin. That's the one. And look up the most recent videos and you'll see these dreams people are having. It is really eye-opening. Pray mighty. Please draw close to God. It's not playtime. Get out the bed. Get out those sheets. Quit playing house. Quit doing what you're big and bad enough to do and start giving God some attention and listen to him speak to your heart. You'll be amazed at how much he does communicate with us if you seek his face. Amen. God bless you.